John, welcome to Barnet. Welcome back to Barnet. What was the motivation behind a move to these?
I've known the chairman from my days here, you know, a few years back now, probably 20 odd years ago, and have always stayed in contact with each other, and so we've built up a good relationship. I think that there's times of your career where things have to change. I don't think it's any secret that Dagenham is my club. It's very unusual, I think, for a manager to manage a club he supported, and I did. I've supported them as a kid. I played for them, and I've managed them at different times. And that time, if I'm being honest, was right for me to move. That's coincided with Barnet's situation. And through conversations with the chairman, we both felt this was a good time for me to come and try and rekindle the flame of the football club, and delighted to work with the chairman again. And I just think sometimes fate plays a part in how things work out, and it was the right time for me to leave Dagenham, and the chairman thought it was the right time for me to come to Barnet, and once we had a talk, that's how it's worked out, so I'm delighted.
You mentioned the club situation. Obviously they put up a fight, but they now find themselves back in the National League. Is the aim, your aim, to return back at the first attempt?
Of course, I think you've got to always aim as high as you can. I'm an experienced manager. I've managed this level in the league for many years now. Success isn't easy to achieve, and I think that people from the outside might look in and say it's a great choice. I've won this league three times. Won promotion from Div 2 to Div 1 and playoffs. But football's not like that. It really isn't. It's, I always say it's not what you've done, it's what you can do. And my aim, as would be the aim of anyone that's going to come and work here for me and for the football club, has got to have the ambition to try and get the club back into the Football League. As I said, it's not easy. I mean, clubs, great respect, like Tranmere, didn't do it first time. Luton, when I went to Luton, I think they'd been 6 or 7 years out of the league, and was fortunate enough to do it there. But it's not easy, and you need everyone pulling in the right direction, everyone to have a belief. And I think experience is important. I really do, to get out of the league. I think it's very important. I'm hoping that my experience and knowledge and hard work from everyone concerned can push us into a situation where we can get promotion.
What can we expect from a Barnet team under your leadership?
Try and win as many games as we can. It's really interesting, isn't it, that, as I say, I was here many years ago, we got in two playoffs. I don't think we always played what might be classed as a beautiful game, but we never had beautiful players. We had some. I think the club is in a position that we can try and entertain, can try and play the type of football that I think I've certainly played at Luton in the last few years at Dagenham. Played some great football, scored some great goals. So we're going to try and be a forceful side and attacking side, but what's really important is that we're an organised side. Organisation and discipline, without those, ability isn't going to shine through. But we want to entertain, we want to excite, and we want to get people supporting the club, not just because we win, but because they enjoy watching us.
As we mentioned, you returned back to the Barnet. It's 15 years since you were last here. How much has the game, especially at this level, changed since then?
The game is becoming incredibly competitive. It's, for players and managers, I think that I was manager of Dagenham for nearly 10 years. That'll never happen again. Long-term managers is very hard. Alex Ferguson and Arsene Wenger at the highest level probably will never happen again, you know, because of how the game is. But I think you can sort of have a plan that you don't sometimes get a chance to implement because results are so important. But I think progression is the key. As long as you can see progress, I think you can see the end of the road. But you know, I have a plan. I have a way of doing things. With the greatest respect, I'm never going to change. I have my beliefs. And why would I change? Because they've been very successful for me. I want to produce players. All the clubs I've had have produced players that have gone on and, you know, had great careers. And I'm not going to change that. You know, I have a belief in how I want to do it. Having said that, that belief has to mirror results a little bit. You know, you can't just have that belief that you want to produce players. You've got to win football matches. But sometimes, in trying to win football matches, you have to see a bigger picture, and you can develop players and bring them on and make them into better players. The team might hold up for a while, but gradually the team goes on a run because what's coming through is getting better and better. And I think it's important to be able to marry those two things, and you know, success but progression for players.
And finally, do you have a message for the Barnet supporters who've been for a lot in recent times and now just want a clean slate and start again?
Yeah, you know, for lots of clubs, it can be difficult times. The club has got relegated. No one wanted that. You know, I have to say this. I am not and have never been a quick fix. Now, I say that we were fortunate enough to win the league at Luton in my first year. I think it took me 3 years, to do it at Dagenham, and it took me 1 year also at Maidstone many years ago. I believe I have the tools that can aid this club to get promotion, but I'm not a quick fix. I have a plan, and I stay to the plan. It's important I stay to the plan. I think that we want anyone that wants success for Barnet to get behind their team, get behind the manager, get behind the staff, create a great atmosphere, enjoy the football. And if we can do that, I believe I can bring success to the football club, I really do. If I didn't, I wouldn't just be coming here to get by, no need to. I have great respect for the chairman. And believe it or not, I have a great respect for this club because I enjoyed my time here. I really did enjoy my time here. And I produced some good players for this club. Marlon King, who went on to play Premier League, Darren Curry, who had a great career, Championship. So we produced good players here and had a good time here. And I'd like to look back at my time here the second time and look at great success that I have helped. Because will I win it on my own? No. Will the supporters win it? No. Will directors win it? No. But all together, we'll be strong. If we're strong, we'll have a great chance.
Thank you, John.
Thank you. Thanks very much.